Monje, thank you so much for joining me. Now, you're a pediatric neuro-oncologist, which means you treat kids with brain cancer. This is obviously a very tragic problem. Is it something that we're making inroads to? Are we seeing any progress in this field?
It's a great question. You know, this is a really important set of pediatric diseases. Pediatric brain tumors are the leading cause of cancer death in kids. And for a long time, we made very little progress. But the last several years have shown some really hopeful signs that we're going to, in fact, be able to make some inroads and make some progress. And a lot of that has come from understanding normal childhood brain development. As we understand that the normal brain develops in these very dynamic, very active ways, we're starting to understand some of the developmental programs that go awry as these brain tumors develop, and that in turn leads us to clues as to how to better treat them.
Can you talk a little bit more about the advances that we've made? What are some things that we know now that maybe 10 or 15 years ago would have been a complete surprise?
Mm-hmm. So there are two main areas that I think have been revolutionary in our understanding of pediatric brain tumors. One is an understanding that these tumors arise not from mature brain cells that accumulate mutations and go bad, as we think about in many forms of adult cancer, but rather in these very active, very plastic precursor cells, stem cells in the brain, that are contributing to normal brain development and through various factors begin to misbehave and produce pediatric brain tumors.
And so it's almost a developmental problem of the brain.
It's very much a developmental problem of the brain. And so as we understand brain development in much more detail with the advent of precision medicine in next generation sequencing, which gives us enormous insight into the DNA material of the cancer cells and the normal development of cells. And as the field of stem cell biology has just taken off in the last decade, we've begun to understand in much more granular detail what exactly is going wrong in development. As a clinician, we know that different brain tumors happen in different parts of the brain at different ages, really strongly suggesting that these are diseases of dysregulated development. And now we're starting to really understand how, and in that understanding, we're getting clues as to how to better treat these diseases.
That's fantastic. What drew you to this field?
It's very motivating to and compelling to take care of a population of patients for whom we can do so little. As a medical student actually here at Stanford, I was just moved by how much work we needed to do and how much these patients needed better therapies.
Well, I remember seeing some of these patients on the wards, and it's really physicians like you that are really helping to make a difference. So thank you so much for speaking with me. I really appreciate it.
It was great to talk.